John.
So you've said
you asked a really good question earlier today, by the way.
Thanks.
That was a good question, I thought. I don't think you got a great answer to that, but I thought that was a great question.
Thanks. So you said a couple times that, like you just said, you believe with all your heart that Jesus Christ is your Savior, and you believe that the prophets are prophets, seers, and revelators. And at what point is that a belief, and at what point is that a knowledge? And that's something that I think a lot of people think about is, and that I think about a lot is like, okay, I believe this, but I wouldn't, there's a lot of things that I, for example, wouldn't say I'm comfortable saying that I know something's true, that I can say, like, I believe it, but at what point does it become that for you, where you can distinguish between I believe versus I know?
It is so, it's such a great question, and I'll tell you, I had this funny conversation, like, last month with my visiting teacher, whom I adore. She is awesome. And she really kind of took me on. And she said, Sherry, it bugs me. Can I say something you do that bugs me? And I said, yeah, sure. Tell me what bugs you. And she said, it bugs me when you get up and say, I know something. I said, like what? What bugs you? And she said, well, like when you get up and say, you know, the Book of Mormon is the Word of God. And I said, I do know that. And she said, no, what you really mean is you believe it. You really believe it. And I said, no, I think I know it. And we really had this very interesting kind of back and forth. And she said, well, just so you know, that really bugs me. And she said, not just you, but you do it all the time. So I'm telling you, you bug me. And so, look, this is what I've come to. There are things today that I believe, and there are things that I know. Okay, and here's how. Eighth section of the Doctrine and Covenants. I will tell you in your mind and in your heart by the Holy Ghost. Now, this is the spirit of revelation. I think revelation has to come to the mind and the heart. And for a long time, I wondered why that was actually. And a lot of times when you read about revelation, it actually talks more about the heart than the mind, actually. And that's kind of curious, too. If you know, don't you think that's your thinker at work? And it finally dawned on me that you cannot convince your brain of something your heart doesn't feel. You know how when somebody tells you something and you say, I'm not really buying that. I don't get that feeling. But I've learned how to tell what it feels like for me when the Spirit is telling me that's true. So I hear it in my mind, I process it in my mind, and at the same time, I have a certain kind of feeling that I've come to recognize. At your age, I did not know the distinction. I didn't know the distinction. I knew what the Spirit felt like. I knew what it felt like to feel the Spirit. I did not know what it felt like to get revelation. And in fact, somewhere in my early 20s, I was trying to make a kind of a difficult life decision, and I fasted and prayed about it a number of times. I couldn't figure out what the answer was. And so I called a friend of mine that's kind of an older brother mentor figure. He and I went to graduate school together, but he was 10 years older than I was when I was in graduate school. He and his wife had become dear friends, and I called him and asked him if he'd give me a blessing. Sure, come on out. So I went out to their house, and he said, now, I know you've been praying and fasting about this. What's the Lord told you? And I said, I can't tell you. And then he asked me this question, and it was one of those moments that was one of those hinges your life turns on. And he said, well, have you? I said, I can't tell. And he said, well, have you asked the Lord to teach you what it feels like for you and what it sounds like for you if he's talking to you? And I said, no, I don't think I've ever asked him. He said, that's a great thing to ask. Ask him. He said, you're asking him to teach you the language of revelation. And you have to learn for you because it'll be different for me. So little by, and he said, here's the rule book for the language of revelation right here. So I started looking at every time there was evidence of direct communication from heaven to somebody on earth and put little checks in my scriptures. And if you open up my scriptures, you'd see that there's little red checks in the margins everywhere. So I started saying, okay, what can I learn about those? Well, so I started trying to learn, and little by little, I've been tutored. When the Lord knows that you want to learn to talk to him, he'll start to teach you how. And what you'll find is he'll lead you to scriptures, and you'll hear talks where you think, oh, there's a little clue, and pretty soon you start to be able to tell, oh, the Spirit is ratifying something I just heard. That's when I think I can say, I know. I heard a prophet say this, or I read this, or I heard a talk in sacrament meeting, and the Spirit says, yeah, that's true. That's when I say I can know. Until I've had that, then it's a belief. But when the Spirit tells me that, and the way I've learned to recognize, I think I can say I know. That's why I know the Savior's my Savior. That's why I know that this is the Word of God, because I've had experiences with it, and it's been ratified here. And there's a lot of stuff I don't know. And I say, yeah, I don't know about that. I haven't figured that out yet. But I want to repeat something I hope I said earlier, and that is, the more experiences you have with the Spirit, the less churned up you get when you have questions. Because you're able to, I may dialogue about it. In fact, I probably will dialogue, because I like dialoguing about things. But if it's not resolved yet, I can let it ride for a while. Because I'm figuring it will get resolved. And it might be tomorrow, but it might be 10 years from now. And it's probably the marriage thing that's allowed me to kind of develop this attitude of better take a longer view.